back to our channel. Adelaide is so... We're currently on our way to Troy's parents' house. We are going to be dropping the... We're going to be dropping the kids off. They are spending the weekend with Grandma and Grandpa while Mom and Dad go to Florida. So we are going to bring you guys along. I just thought I would start the vlog now so you can see our lovely children. Remember days I used to hide hands in the treasure, yeah. Wanted to be happy, but happiness took effort. I seen my niggas and my mom on the stretch. We all battling obstacles in life, and I know it come with a challenge. But to me, what separates the good from greatness is the way you choose to handle it. We're finally in Florida. It is
late.
We had quite the experience at Chick-fil-A. They completely forgot about us. They completely forgot about us, and 25 minutes later, I said something.
I just kept texting Troy saying, OMG, 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 and then I told him I was going to come make a scene. So after that, then he went up there.
No, I went up like 3 times for that. But anyways, we eventually got our food, and then Sam made a mess of herself a few times.
Oh yeah, I spilled, and I got hot sauce and Chick-fil-A sauce all over my sweatpants. And then while we're on the plane, Troy was half asleep still, and I opened up my water bottle, and my water bottle literally just like spouted, like fell onto my back, fell all over my leg, fell on my butt, like on the seat, like
yeah,
absolutely horrid.
The pressure of the plane in her water bottle. So we're gonna go get one drink at the bar.
I need a drink after this day.
And then get ready for bed.
Balance,
tightrope walking, but you balance it. Balance, tightrope walking, but you balance. Sorry, it is Thursday.
Thursday,
so we are sitting by the pool. It's not very sunny.
Troy's been working all morning, so I took the morning to put my face on.
We currently just checked out of our first hotel. So last night we stayed in Orlando. We're hanging out in Orlando, you know, this afternoon. Today we have an appointment to meet with the designers for our builder to pick out our interior finishes. And from there we're headed over to Tampa for the next 2 days. So, the valet with that, I probably put it on. He like cranked up the AC. So we're very much neutrals in this house. The house that we currently live in, we basically renovated it to make it all neutrals. So there's like carpet all over the house, because that's like the cheapest option. So we're definitely looking to get vinyl flooring. Is that what it is? Vinyl flooring, in the main living spaces. So the living room, kitchen, hallways downstairs. The house that we're moving, that we're building, is a two-story house. So we would like the entire house to be vinyl flooring, but with upgrades and everything, it just might not be possible for the time being. So main living space is downstairs, our bedroom, your office space downstairs, and then and then all white cabinets. Did I say that already?
No, I think the most important things for us are definitely the flooring.
Flooring, cabinets.
Because we have dark flooring in our house right now.
Yeah, which is brutal when you have two large dogs. You can see everything on the floor. So we definitely don't want dark floors.
Yeah, white cabinets.
White cabinets. We would like to see black hardware, but we might end up have Troy just do that after we move in.
Yeah, we're going to really focus on the things that you can't, like, change after, like the flooring, the cabinets.
Yeah, the sinks. That's our game plan for the day. I would like to... So yesterday, we touched on the fact that I spilled hot sauce and Chick-fil-A sauce on my sweatpants. So I'm trying to talk Troy into bringing me to Target now so I can get some Tide to Go so that I can get that stain out.
I've never gotten Tide to Go to actually work.
Yeah, me either. So maybe we'll just get like a stain spray.
Yeah, I don't think Tide to Go actually works.
Hopefully we can get that out stat. We could get like just like a mini laundry detergent, and I could just like soak my sweatpants in like a sink. So that I can really get that stain out. I mean, they're my favorite sweatpants. I wear them all the time. So I have to get the stain out, or else I'm just going to look dirty.
Then we're going to head out to Tampa.
Tampa for the night. And Troy actually...
There's a Restoration Hardware out there.
Yeah. We don't have those in upstate New York. We've never been to one. Yeah, no. We don't have a lot of things that the South has. So we're excited to explore... And
there's, see what it's like. We've never been there.
Yeah. I mean, we've like gone on the website a million bajillion times, but I would like to go to Restoration Hardware. They have, I sent you like a bunch of different stores that they have. I want to go to Urban Outfitters. Yeah. Even though I don't have any room left in my suitcase.
Yeah, this mall is like has
restaurant place.
Well, it's like the mall, it's like the mall, and then so in Tampa, it's called International Plaza, which is the mall. And then there's Bay Street, which has a bunch of restaurants. I sound like I know what I'm talking about, but this is just all for me Googling stuff all day. Yeah,
Troy researches a lot. So we're going to an NHL game.
Yep.
So, which I've never been to.
I
have no idea. And then the following day, we're going to a Yankees game. Woohoo!
Yep. Yankee spring training game.
That's more my alley.
Toodaloo. Tell me if you wanna, cause I got this feeling. I wanna hear you say it, cause I can't believe it. With every touch of you, it's like I've started dreaming. Cause heaven's not that far away.
Should have got my sunglasses out.
So it's the next day. Last night when we got into Tampa, we went to International Plaza and went out to dinner. And just walked around a little bit. Stairs.
So yeah, we're going to International Plaza. We're headed to our car now. We're gonna go there. We're going to, where are we going first? Crate and Barrel?
Yeah.
We're going to Crate and Barrel first.
We wanna go back to Restoration Hardware. So that these are like some stores that New York, well, where we live in New York, they do not have these stores.
Yeah, we went into Restoration Hardware for like 10. Like 5 minutes in.
It's really just to explore and get some inspiration for our new house.
Yeah, it was really cool in there. All right.
Some fruity. All right, let's get there. Spinning round inside this room.
Hey, hey, won't you come on over? I'm a sucker for you. Wishing we'll be out here soon. So tell me if you wanna, cause I got this feeling. I wanna hear you say it, cause I can't believe it. With every touch of you, it's like I've started dreaming. Cause heaven's not that far away. And I'll be singing la 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 la.
Yeah, so we went to Crate and Barrel. You're breaking me la la
la la la. We really liked, but overall, a little underwhelming.
I thought you were going to say that. I liked it. I did. But Restoration Hardware and iCare both have very similar... They're not similar by any means, but they're similar with the way that they set up like rooms to make it look like rooms. Yeah. So it's not just like a bunch of different things thrown all over the place.
So you can like
really, so you can really visualize what the room would look like. So we really liked that, and Crate and Barrel didn't have that. But with that being said, they did have some gorgeous pieces that we are very interested in for when we make our move down here. So
definitely some affordable stuff.
And then, we stopped in Sephora really quick.
Yeah, we couldn't really like buy much at stores because we'd have to bring it home with us on the plane.
Yeah, and we don't, neither of us have any room in our bags. So it's unrealistic for us to even be purchasing anything. But I got this. It's the new Sol de Janeiro. It's the pink one. That's all I can say. It smells delicious. I just ordered the big one back home. I'm obsessed with it. I love it. Troy loves when I put it on. He thinks it smells delicious as well.
So she was using the Lux.
Oh, the Lux Unfiltered. What is it? Santal? Santal?
Yeah.
Is that how you say it?
Yeah, I thought that smelled horrible.
I love the smell of that, but I love the smell of this.
This smells pretty good.
This smells delicious. So I got the travel size because what I have right now is a carry-on and just another bag. So this for when we make our travels.
And then I needed, so I've never actually had that used this foundation, the NARS Sheer Glow Foundation. I've used all of their other foundations. But this is in the shade Syracuse. I use Syracuse with all of my NARS foundations, and they didn't have Syracuse in any others, which is why I purchased this.
Then we went to Restoration Hardware.
Yeah.
For like the full tour.
That place is
sick. Unreal. It was so cool. Just, I think the biggest thing for me was like just the size of everything. Like the ceilings are probably like 16 feet high.
We really are looking at getting bigger pieces for this house compared to what we have in our current house.
Well, think,
and really
yeah.
investing in good quality pieces over...
I mean, probably not Restoration Hardware.
Oh, no way. No way.
But not that crazy. But
no,
it's cool. It was just cool to visualize like stuff. I think
it was just cool to see. I don't care. Other than that, there is no way we're spending that amount of money on furniture or decorations, anything.
I mean, I think like maybe some of it's worth it. You know, you'll like have it forever, but you know, we don't know that. So
we also have two dogs and two cats. So realistically, we're not going to get pieces of furniture that we're going to be spending a fortune on just for them to get ruined.
So my two biggest takeaways, I think, were size, like just having big pieces, big sizes, big...
like artwork.
Just big everything.
Decorative.
Like they had like geodes or crystals or whatever you want to call them. They were like,
oh my gosh,
literally like stones. So those were cool. So I think it was was big for me. Just the simplicity of how like simple everything was.
Simple and clean.
And then symmetry. Like every single room was like, if you cut it down the middle, it was exactly the same on the other half. Like mirrors on each side of the bed, same lamp, same as anything. Which we have at our current house, but I think just doing more of that. Like there's symmetry in a lot of their stuff. But,
symmetry?
Yeah.
Symmetry.
Symmetry.
It's symmetry.
It's symmetry.
It's sim. S-Y-M-M-E-T.
It's not S-I-M.
I said S-Y-M.
That's why
symmetry.
It's symmetry.
You're saying cemetery.
Yeah, like a cemetery.
Like a cemetery. It's
yeah.
Symmetry.
Anyways,
oh my god, now I'm messing up.
And then the coolest part was they had like a rooftop terrace for their outdoor furniture.
That was so cool.
It was so cool. It overlooks the Tampa airport, but there was just like live greenery everywhere. Mm-hmm. It was so lush up there. And just awesome. They had an outdoor table down the middle that probably sat like 20 people.
Yeah, we live in upstate New York, so having
like
nice plants,
tropical greenery yeah.
is currently not in the cards for us because we don't live in a tropical place.
You could probably have it for like 1 month.
Yeah, moving here, we're really excited to be able to have some of that stuff like around the house, out in our screened-in patio area. Hopefully in our backyard eventually.
So we came back to the hotel. We're about to take an Uber. We're gonna go down to Tampa Boardwalk.
You know what it's
called. Tampa Riverwalk. So it looks like there's a bunch of cool stuff down there. It looks really cool at night. And then the Tampa Bay Lightning's arena is right, kind of right there.
But I think we're wearing the right color because I'm pretty sure they're blue, right?
Yeah, I planned it that way. I did anyways.
Yeah, I didn't, but
so
I mean, we're
gonna
the right color.
We're gonna be Lightning's fans for the night. I still can't remember who they're playing. I want to say like Chicago or something.
Who cares? It's gonna be fun. It's gonna
yeah.
be something new for
Sam's
me
never been
specifically.
To an NHL game,
yeah,
so.
Yeah. Only have gone to like the minor league games, which is still fun. Hockey's fun to watch, so it'll be fun. Have some nice drinks and really enjoy ourselves.
We're gonna do a little bar crawl down to the arena.
So. Sure, it's gonna be crawling. I'm gonna be hopping.
So, yep, so Sam will probably fall asleep during the game if she drinks too much, and then we'll be on the kiss cam, and, you know, she'll be asleep. So.
And he'll be kissing my forehead. Do they have kiss cams at hockey games?
I think so, usually.
Bye!
We're on the Riverwalk.
We're headed to the game. So we stopped. This place that we went to was like this cute little wine bar.
Well, so we went to this place called Armature Works, which is a...
Now, mind you, neither of us have been here before, so no. This is the first time that we've gone.
So this is it's a food hall. So if you've been to Nashville, there's one in Nashville that's really famous, but it's a food hall. So there's I don't know, maybe 20 different places you can eat.
Yeah.
Like all different varieties.
So
there's
many bars.
Tacos, Mediterranean,
ice cream.
Whatever. So
dessert.
We weren't that hungry, so we found a wine bar.
So we got a charcuterie board.
Yep, just something light.
And it's so fun when we end up like talking to the people, to like the people that are working.
Yeah.
And we tell them that we're from upstate New York, we're moving here soon, and yada yada yada. And basically, it's like everyone's constantly reassuring us that like this is the best thing that we can be doing. So
we got a couple drinks. We're walking down to the
game.
I guess it is a game.
This wine is really good.
Oh, the lady at the wine bar was telling us about a dog bar.
A dog park that has a bar.
Yeah, that's right up our alley. So.
Yeah, we're excited to be able to bring our babies here.
I think our biggest takeaway so far for the day of this part is, at least come, like, if you're curious about moving somewhere, like, go experience it. Like, just, if you can, I mean, obviously everyone has different, like, abilities, but if you can, go there, try it out, spend a weekend there, spend a long, like, a week there, see what it's like. But try it out, you know, go there, see what it's like, and you'll, I mean, if you come to Tampa, you're probably going to want to stay here.
I mean, every place in Florida, we end up wanting to stay, so.
No, it's like, really nice here. So we're on the Riverwalk, and we're going to keep heading down and get to the conversation. Game. Bay Lightning won. Woo. Go Bolts. I think one game officially did us in. We're officially Tampa Bay Lightning fans.
Troy was like, oh, it doesn't take much to make me easily influenced.
So I've loved hockey for like probably 3 years now, but I still haven't decided on a team. Definitely leaning towards Tampa Bay Lightning.
Again,
now, so.
It doesn't take much for him to be influenced.
Sam's but a big Tampa Bay Lightning fan,
it was actually a lot of fun.
So, had a great time. They won 5-2. So, we're walking back around the river walk again.
Yeah, we have to find a slower area that doesn't have as much traffic going so that we can order an Uber. Because we knew that we were going to be having some fun tonight. So, we decided that we were going to Uber here, even though we rented a car this entire weekend. But it's fine. We are being responsible human beings. So go us. So yeah. And then head back to the hotel for the night. I am absolutely knackered because Troy woke me up at 5:30 a.m. this morning, whispering in my ears, what do you want from Starbucks?
I was writing a Yelp review at 5 a.m.
It was literally, I'm like, what? He's like, what do you want from Starbucks? I'm going to Starbucks. I'm like, you literally just woke me up for that.
Gotta
and
write.
Then I was awake since.
Gotta write them Yelp reviews, you know?
Yeah. He wants to get into Yelp more. Because we use it a lot. So, yeah. We'll catch up with you in the morning, okay? Good night. Okay, just a quick update. It's the next day. It's our last full day here in Florida.
Yeah.
And we're headed to the Yankees game now. So, we'll bring you guys along. All right, GPS time. Bye. The last time you guys saw us, we were on our way to the Yankees game. That game, we stayed for about 5 innings. Yankees were up like 8-0. Ended up downpouring, torrential rainstorm. Yep. And
we saw Aaron Judge get a homer his first at bat.
Yep. And then on the way home, we stopped at our development that we're building our house in. And we took some measurements of the model house because they have the model house there. And then the following day, we were supposed to be heading out at 6 a.m. We woke up at around 2 a.m. so we could be out the door by 3:15 because we had to drop our car off. We wanted to have enough time to go to Starbucks because last time we flew out of this airport, it was insanely busy. So we wanted to basically be the first people at the airport. So we woke up very early.
woke up to our flight being canceled.
Yeah, so. I woke up and I got the email notification. Then Sam woke up and I was like, well, not to freak you out, but our flight got canceled.
So, and the thing is, there were like no other flights, even in like the vicinity, like in Florida, Georgia, South Carolina, like there were no other flights to New York.
Yeah, we couldn't fly into like New York City, Syracuse, literally nothing. Like we couldn't even get close. Like
we looked
Boston.
Yeah, and all of like the airports and airlines like had insane, you know, prices for like last minute flights.
Yeah, it would have been flights. Like, I don't know, like $2,000 per person.
Yeah, so it was just ridiculous. So Troy ended up finding a flight out of Punta Gorda. And I went on to confirm, pay, and book the flight. And it was literally, quite literally, the only two seats available to New York that morning. Like, the only ones. And it was about 3 hours away from where we were located. So I went on, booked it, got the confirmation email, went into the email. Email was gone, went back to the webpage. Webpage said that, oops, something went wrong. So we're like, what the frig? So we ended up trying to book it like a million other times. It didn't work. It wasn't working. And then it said that the flight was completely booked.
Yeah, sold out.
Or sold out or whatever.
Yeah.
So we ended up laying there. Yeah, just like
we just accepted the fact that we were going to be stuck in Florida for another day.
Yeah, and it just sucked because I had my first day of my new job the following day on Monday. So I was just like, this is just great. Like, what a great excuse for me to not show up to my first day of work. So that was just very upsetting to me.
Like, yeah, sorry, I'm stranded in Florida.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, sure you are.
Yeah. So that was crappy. And then, so we basically were laying there for like 3 hours because we couldn't go back to sleep. I was unbelievably stressed out. I had a stomach ache. I just wanted to be home at that point. When I like get my mind on the fact that like we were supposed to be going home, like I need to get home. So then Troy was like, okay, we can consider like driving home. And it just didn't make any sense.
It was like 20 hours.
Yeah. So then he ended up getting an email probably like three and a half hours later, basically saying like, you have to check in. So we're like, what the heck? So we both went on. I tried checking in with just like the last four of my card number that we paid for with the flight, for the flights, because we didn't get a confirmation number. Went on, there's our flights, there's our seats, there's our tickets. Ridiculous.
Yeah, so the doors closed from we're sitting in our hotel room in Orlando, the doors closed in Punta Gorda at
7:25.
No, I think they started boarding. Doors closed at 7:55. And it was like, I'm trying to backtrack time. It was like 5 a.m. and it's probably 2.5 hour drive. So like we have like we will show up at the airport, not even get through security, like with like 25 minutes left to go before doors close. So
and we have to also take into consideration that we have to drop off our rental car, just get through security.
Thankfully, we didn't have bags to check.
Yeah, and the thing is that we've never been in this airport, so we walk in, the line is like out the door, so we're like, great, like we're screwed. And then we hear them like say something about the area that we're supposed to be flying into. So we like run forward because they're like saying like last call. So we're thinking that they're like boarding, like we need to go.
Right.
So we run up and then we realize that it was for people that had to check bags. And they're like, oh, you have 30 seconds. So then we're like, oh no, we don't. And then I was like, can somebody direct us to security? And then I was like, we're completely scrambled. Like, we have no idea what we're doing. We've never been in this airport. Troy was like, our flight got canceled out of Orlando.
Yeah.
And this guy literally saved the day and moved us to the front of security and got us through security like that. And we made it before they even started boarding.
Yeah. So we're just so, like, we got so lucky and like
so unbelievably lucky because so many people
wasn't traffic on the way there. Like everything that had to go right thankfully did go right and we made it on the flight. And it was a full flight. There was literally two empty seats on the entire plane.
And we really did get lucky. Like so many of my friends on Facebook like were posting about how they were stuck in Florida until like at least Wednesday, and that would have just been unfortunate for me and my situation with having to get back to New York so I can start my first day at my new job. Yep. So
we made it back.
And we are back with our kids.
Yep.
And I started my new job on Monday. So back in New York for like the next 3 months, and then we'll be headed down to Florida. Whether we're in a short-term rental, most likely, I'm coming to terms with it. And then we'll be there until our house is done being built. So
that is all for this one.
Yep. Adios. We'll see you in the next one.